E-mini S&Ps close out the week with an afternoon rally. After opening lower early in the session, we rallied in the afternoon, getting back north of unchanged and north of 5250, actually extending the afternoon rally north of 5300, closing up on the day significantly, however, still closing slightly lower on the week, but ending the month of May higher. So over the last 7 months, we've seen six monthly higher closes, including today. And again, seeing E-minis close very close to 5300. Now, early in the session, we had the PCE data, which came in as expected, but that was followed by the Chicago Purchasing Managers data, which came in at its lowest since June of 2020, helping to nudge those Fed rate cut odds slightly higher, seeing about 60% odds of a rate cut in September, while the market is still fully pricing its first rate cut out to November at November FOMC. But again, seeing E-minis with a big rally closing higher to end the week. Now, what does this mean for volatility? Well, as we've talked about, volatility moves inversely to the indices. So as we saw indices rallying into the afternoon today, volatility was lower. Now, it did still settle slightly higher on the week, but the big move higher pushed vols lower on the session. Lastly, let's talk about what we have next week. Next week, we get the S&P PMIs, we get the ISM data, but ultimately, everyone's going to be looking, waiting, and watching for the May employment report, which comes out on Friday, which will be preceded by ADP and jobless claims on Wednesday and Thursday. So ultimately, jobs will be the big focus next week. And one other note, there will be no Fed speakers next week as they enter into their Fed blackout period ahead of June FOMC. So after a down day in equities that saw a big afternoon rally extend to 5,300 in E-mini S&Ps, we close higher on the day, lower on the week, and higher on the month for the sixth time in the last 7 months.